Okay, welcome everyone to our annual Christmas pageant. And today we have quite a production, I would say. It's very nice to have it down here at the Social Center. This is our first time doing it in a long time. And but it's nice to have a stage set up, and it was a great place for the kids to rehearse. So our first part of the program is going to be the classes of Miss Gada, Miss Yvonne, and Miss Megan with student helper Naomi Marulovich. And they're going to do a little reciting of the symbols of Christmas. And they're going to sing a special, We Wish You a Merry Christmas. So let's bring them out. Let's give them a nice round of applause. I think they're still getting their props. They'll be out in a second.
Here they come. Yay!
Star?
A heavenly sign, the birth of Jesus, the shining hope of mankind. Red, the first color of Christmas, the Savior's sacrifice for all. Green, the second color of Christmas, saving light and life. The shepherd cook on its staff. The reef, no ending for all mankind.
Today, and I'm sure most of you are familiar with the Grinch Who Stole Christmas, but today we have a different twist on the play. It is going to be the Grinch Who Found Christmas, and the ending is a little bit different. The students in these classes are from Mr. Semolenko, Connie Carroll, Mr. Dudko, and Father Peter. So we have students that are in second grade all the way up to high school in this play. And I'm very, very excited about it. I've had so much fun with them, and I think you're going to be very impressed with their performance for today. So without further ado, what is the title? Holy cow, I forgot. The Grinch Who Found Christmas. Too many things.
Thank you. But the Grinch, who lived just north of Whoville, did not.
The Grinch hated Christmas the whole Christmas season.
Now please don't ask why. No one quite knows the reason.
It could be that his head wasn't screwed on just right.
But I think that the most likely reason of all
may have been his heart was two sizes too small.
But whatever the reason, his heart or his shoes, he stood there on Christmas Eve, hating the Whos, staring down from his cave with a sour, grinchy frown at all the warm-hearted Whovilles below in their town.
And they're hanging their stockings for old Saint Nick.
He snarled with a sneer. I must think quick.
I must find a way to stop Christmas from coming. I thought. My mind is not running.
For tomorrow, he knew, all the Who girls and all the Who boys would wake up bright and early to play with their toys.
They'd rush for their stockings and open their presents.
Then go to church to pray and show their reverence.
Oh, the praying and praying he hated the most. It haunted his mind, just like a ghost.
The Whos, young and the old, would then sit down to a feast.
And they'd feast and they'd feast, from the most to the least.
And they'd laugh and they'd play in a merry old way.
With love in their hearts, both young and old.
It warmed their souls, so they are told.
And then they do something he liked least of all.
All the Whos in Whoville, the tall and the small,
would stand close together with Christmas bells ringing.
They'd stand hand in hand and the Whos would start singing.
And they'd sing and they'd sing a most beautiful tune.
Even sometimes at night, under the moon.
This Who Christmas sing, the more the Grinch thought,
I must stop this whole thing!
Then he got an idea. A really awful idea.
I know just what to do, and I'll carry it through.
The Grinch then laughed in his throat, then threw on his red coat.
On his hat upon his head.
And opened his mouth and then he said,
I'm going to ruin the Who's holiday. I must leave now. I must leave right away.
He then grabbed a red sack, threw it swift on his back.
As he thought of this plan, this most sinister plan.
He curled his lips in a nasty grin.
With his soul so black and full of sin.
He took.
And in his greed, he never did look.
And as the tree, he tried to take with him too. He was startled by the sight of Cindy Lou Who.
Shocked by her query, and his eyes became weary.
Then one by one, and two and three, the Who's woke up, and he couldn't flee.
Christmas is not just, you see. It's found in our hearts. It's God's love, you see.
The story of Christmas will now be told as the angel begins with the story of old. The Grinch was surprised and overwhelmed. He decided to listen. He had nothing to lose.
In a land from afar of wise men bearing gifts who followed a star. They came to the manger where Jesus was born, and the shepherds knelt down and the child they adorned. Fear not, for behold, I bring you tidings of joy, the angel proclaimed, of this baby boy. For unto you today this child is here, wrapped in swaddling clothes, but do not fear. Mary brought forth her only son, Joseph his father. This is God's will, and his will be done. His name will be Jesus. His love is for all, the bad and the good, the short and the tall. He will die on the cross, and for all of our sins, he will fight what is evil, his pure love will win. Jesus opened heaven's gates for all of our souls, so that we may live and never grow old.
First Christmas Day, so let us give praise in a musical way.
Come, let us join hands in a song we will sing of joy and of love, good tidings we bring.
Healing, wise men follow in a star. For
Grinch was dumbfounded by all the who's, and his heart just got so big, it just grew and it grew.
The music and words made his soul overflow, and the love in his heart made his face glow.
He pulled out his sack and gave out the toys to all the who little girls and boys.
And to Cindy Lou Who as he patted her head. And he gave her a doll, and to everyone said,
I now know the meaning. I'll tell you, I see. It's the gift of his love, not what's under the tree. Forgive me, Who people, for taking your things. Let us all join hands, and then Carol will sing. And after our singing, and bells that are ringing, let's join in the feast as I carve the roast beast!
Let's give them all a great round of applause.